get a piece of 40 by 5 millimeter steel, mark out with a set square an 80 millimeter line, then we put it in a bandsaw and cut it. Put the plate in the V-plate holder, clamp it in the wood vise, then mark out the lines to cut the shape of the V-plate, then mark the hole with an 8mm drill. Two things we do now. Scratch so we know where to cut it to. The hole. And this hole we finish on the drill press, drill all the way through, first at 8mm and then at 15mm, and we'll show that in a minute. Put the V-plate in a vise on the drill press, then drill an 8mm hole. After that, put a 15mm drill into the drill press. This is a drill with a tapered shank, so don't use the chuck, but put it in the drill press direct. Keep going. All right. Let's do this here. Now drill a 15mm hole in the V-plate. Gonna cut these bits off and then file it nice and even. Angles off, 15mm hole, ready to go. First I'm going to face off this pipe. It's a pipe of outside diameter about 32mm, ID about 26mm. Put it on 2500 RPM. Now we're gonna part it off. Parting tool, lock it in. Needs to be 3mm. The ring needs to be 3mm. Yep. We will put it on 440 RPM. So it's that one goes to 1, and 2, 440 RPM. And part it off. It's important that you do this in a nice smooth movement so the tool doesn't break. There's the ring. All I need to do is let it cool down and clean it on the linisher. And just finish it off with a deburring tool, just nicely clean it up a bit. And it's ready to be welded.